You're not disciplined in your faith. Some of you are too busy for God. But if you ever want to become a student of God, you got to stay connected. Look at your neighbors and you got to plug into the power source. Amen. If the sound system was not plugged into the power source, we would not have no audible sound here. You got to stay connected because in him is life and life more abundantly. I know I ain't going to get no help in here today because we want to mosey along and do our own thing. But Jesus said ye are clean through the word. And the word of God is what cleans us up. He said that I have spoken unto you. He said, abide in me and I in you. He said, apart from me, you can do nothing. Look at your neighbor and say, how long you want to try to do your own thing? Amen. You tried it and it still ain't work. And you find yourself right back to God. Oh, I wish I had some people in here that know what I'm talking about. Amen. He said, my way is easy and my burden is light. Jesus said, take his yoke upon me and learn me because, amen, my yoke is easy. Look at your neighbor like you're going to look him down to the floor. He says, a branch cannot bear a fruit of itself. Stop talking to yourself, amen, and start talking to God. You know who you are, our word. You are the worst person to give yourself some advice. And that's why you got to get in the word of God. And so he makes it very plain. He said the branch cannot bear fruit of itself except it abide in the vine. Oh, you've been trying to do it your way for a long time and it ain't working. Tell your neighbors that it ain't working. Amen. But I made my mind up that I'm going to stick with Jesus. Oh, it might be a slow process, but tell your neighbor it's a sure thing. Oh, we should have some people in there that know what I'm talking about. Said I've been running for the Lord for a long time. I ain't tired yet. Why? Because I got my mind made up. It ain't whether or not I'm coming to church on Sunday. It's just what time I'm going to get there. Because every time the doors open, I'm going to be in the praise of the Lord. Why? Because I know that my blessings come from God. I know that when I stick with God, I can't go wrong. Is there anybody know what I'm talking about? You got to stop detouring off the road and trying to take a shortcut. Amen. And come on in through the door. Jesus said, I set before you an open door. Now walk through the door. The many folk, amen, want to take a right turn when they should be going left, Brother Russell. They want to take a yield sign when they should be stopping. Oh, but God told me to come by and tell you tonight you've got to get connected. You see, Jesus considered the vine as the church, the believer as the church, the branches. And the vine is the power source. You see, Christianity is not just a religion, but it is a relationship. For so many believers think that Christianity or being a Christian is about religion, but the reality of it is it's about having a relationship. So whether I'm in the church or I'm out in the church or in my car, I can lift my hands and say, thank you, God. Why? Because you've been so good to me. I can say, thank you, Lord, because when all the hellhounds will try to kill me, then let them kill me, Lord. I can say, thank you, because when they tried to have my funeral, amen, you resurrected me like you did Lazarus. Is there anybody in here know just what I'm talking about? I can say, thank you, Lord, because when everything else failed, Lord God, you were there all the time. I can say, thank you, Lord, when folk turn their back on you. When Negroes talk about you, amen, you made them a liar right in their face. I can say, thank you, Lord, because you are my shepherd, and I shall not want. I can say, thank you, because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, and it all belongs to you. I can say, thank you, because you got my back, amen, when there's nobody else that's been there. I can say, thank you, and that's why I do what I do. I do it because you've been so good to me. Oh, but is there anybody know just what I'm talking about? And so Jesus said, listen, the time gonna come, brother, and sisters, where the rubber gonna meet the road, and you gonna have to stay connected. A time gonna come and your faith is gonna be on trial. And if you're gonna go, you got to go all the way. Because the Bible said, no man that put his hand to the plow will kingdom. Tell your neighbor, said, I tried him and I found out that what he's all right. Did anybody know what I'm talking about? I ain't talking about my grandmother's testimony. She had her own testimony, but I got my own testimony. I was bought with a price. Oh my God, does anybody know what I'm talking about? You ought to go and tell God, thank you. The car that you're driving, the house that you're living in, and the apartment that you got, I don't care if you got a one bedroom, you got to learn how to thank him. I don't care if you got a hookah, you got to learn how to thank him. Or I don't care if you got a piece of job, thank him for everything that he has done, but stay connected. Come hell or high water, I got to stay connected, brother. I'm so glad, amen, that my relationship is not predicated upon anybody else, but my relationship is predicated on God, and that's why I stay connected, and that's why I rise up early to give him praise, and that's why I stay up late to pray and pray to him. Why? Because nobody can do me like Jesus. And so the Bible says, he said, I am the vine. He said, Moses, tell him that I am. Other words, I'll be what you want me to be. I'll be a doctor if you need healing. I'll be a banker if you need some money. I'll be a bridge over troubled water. I'll be water when you're thirsty. I'll be food when you're hungry. Whatever you want, I am. And the word I am mean I am the self-existing one. I was there before David. I was there before Paul. I was there before Nehemiah. I was there before the world. Amen. Amen. Was up a birth before anything came. There was God. He's the God that knows the very numbers of hair that are on your head. God said, stop playing me cheap. And that's the problem with y'all. Y'all play God cheap like he's a cheap trick. You only want God when you're in trouble. But he said, I'll stop you from going in trouble if you stay connected. I'll keep you out of trouble. If you stay connected, I'll keep you from the bloodsuckers. If you just stay connected. Tell your neighbor, say, you're going to stay connected, it's going to cost you. If you're going to stay connected, you want to lose some friends who ain't connected. Hey, man, you can't roll with people if they don't want your God. Oh, some people only want God, amen, just for a season. But tell your neighbor, say, I want him. I want him in the morning. I want him in the evening. He is the air I breathe. Oh, y'all ain't saying nothing. He's the one that woke me up this morning and started me on my way and gave me a mind to serve him. Who wouldn't serve a God like that? If a man abide not in me, why would Jesus say that? Because there's some folk who ain't going to abide no matter what word they hear, no matter who preaches. They have made their mind up and they still got time to play. But tell your neighbors that God is getting ready to call every card. God is getting ready to pull your card. God is getting ready to expose your life.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Abide, to ride with, to stay connected. He said, if you don't abide now, he said, you won't be cast forth. God said, get ready to cast you out if you don't abide. Keep on playing with him. Keep on taking God for a joke. Keep on thinking that you got time to get back. One of these times you ain't gonna make it back. Keep on trying to ride on the grace of God. Or y'all ain't gonna help me preach up in here. Keep on taking the grace of God and taking his liberty for granted. One of these times you're not gonna make it back. One of these times you're gonna be sitting in the ICU and God gonna pull a cord on you and you're not gonna make it.
Woo, Jesus. You better preach. God.
God is tired of us taking his grace for granted. God is tired of us taking him for granted. Taking him for a joke like God is something to play. If you want to get blessed, stay connected.
Amen.
Yes.
He told the disciples, he said, if you abide in me and I in you, he said, anything you ask me, he said, I'll give it to you.
Yes, Lord.
God said, I dare you to ask me for something.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
When you're living right and you're walking right, you can command the blessing to come in your life. When you're living right and you're walking right, the whole kingdom belongs to you.
My God.
And tell your neighbor, say, the kingdom is bigger than your little block. Bigger than your neighborhood.
Yes, Lord.
Bigger than your friends.
Yes.
Bigger than your problem. When you begin to see God, amen, as your solution, come on, say amen. Hallelujah. When you begin to see God bigger than the challenges that you're going through, you will stay connected. The reason why people can't stay connected is because they want to do it on their own.
I know that's right.
Tell your neighbor, say, I'm in a blessed place. I'm in a blessed place because I am connected. And you know when you're connected. When you're connected, stuff starts to happen for you. Stuff starts to fall into your lap. Contracts start to come. Business deals start to come. You start to get blessed. You don't even know why you're being blessed. But you're connected. Come on, say amen. Amen. The Bible says, amen. When you got favor with God, he'll give you favor with men. Then your neighbor say, favor ain't fair.
Woo, Jesus. Glory, Jesus.
I got favor all over me.
Yeah.
Favor says everything I touch is going to prosper. See, it says hard to preach prosperity to people who have a mentality that they're going to be broke all the time. If you don't expect God to give you nothing, if you don't expect God to do nothing for you, why pray?
That's right. Amen. Amen.
No. See, when I'm connected to God, it doesn't matter who's handing my blessing. I'm going to get my blessing because I'm connected to God. Because God will make them loose what belongs to me.
Oh,
and say, what's for me? It is for me. Can't go devil in hell. Stop what's for you. I don't care who's in front of you when you get there. Amen. Your blessing, I don't care how qualified it is. You may not even be qualified for the position. Amen. You may not even be qualified for the contract. But if something will make the person who got the money, amen, see, it'll make a resume jump out and say, call that person, bless that person. Come on, say amen. They may not be educated, but they got favor. Oh, I always ask some people in here. It ain't about your education or your intellect. It's going to take the favor of God to move in on your behalf.
Hallelujah. Glory, Jesus. Glory. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Some of us come to church because we just come to church. We ain't really expecting nothing there. We're not expecting nothing. We just come because if we come out of a routine, we're not even connected. No. I come in, I expect the church to grow. I expect the praise team to get better. I expect the power of God to be in the church. I expect my kids to be blessed. I expect the members to be blessed. I expect God to do some things in your life and stuff that you've been praying for. I expect God to do it. Do you expect God to do it? If you don't expect Him to do it, then stay home. Waste your time and get up. You gotta have some radical faith. You gotta let the devil know, yes, I might be going through something, but I'm gonna stay connected. Oh God, I might feel like giving up, but I'm gonna stay connected. Because every time I come, the praise team is singing, and they push me a little harder. Every time I come, Sister Watkins is praying, and I get my strength. Every time I come, I see them faithful, and they say, Pastor, you can do it. Why? Because we are pushing you. Oh, because when God blesses you, He blesses us. I want you to know that the blessing flows from the head. It don't flow up, it flows down. So when your head is blessed, your family is blessed. When your husband is blessed, the whole house is blessed. Some of y'all got cursed heads, and that's why you can't get blessed. I want every man in here to be blessed. So they can take their rightful place. And like God called you from the beginning to be blessed. The women don't want bozo, they want